Orleans on the crest of a wave of fanaticism that was sweeping the country. A near riot that night at City Park Stadium, thousands of teenagers inside to see the phenomenon sweeping the country. Among those teenagers, a high school sophomore named Marcia Cavanaugh, who now looks back to that night and to the New Orleans of today, reacting in shock to Lennon's death.
You were crying all night?
All night. God. Couldn't believe it. It was more shock than anything.
A John Lennon fan in New Orleans echoes the sentiments of people worldwide. Record stores in New Orleans and across the country reported brisk sales of Lennon records today. People eager to keep a small part of a man who contributed to big changes in music and lifestyle.
I want the last thing that John Lennon did. He was a genius.
The Sanger Theater downtown quickly arranged a free memorial to Lennon to be held Wednesday. That's about a week before the show Beatlemania comes to town. Radio stations played Lennon's music. For some, it was a small consolation.
Well, I'd love to hear it.
Get it on for you just a bit.
Well, I'm really sorry to hear about his death.
No doubt, the biggest Beatle event to happen in New Orleans happened here, Tag Gormley Stadium in City Park. That was 16 years ago.
The Beatles. John, Paul, George, and Ringo were barely out of Liverpool when they took this country by storm. New Orleans was one stop on a tour. It was a September night in 1964, and the scene at City Park was pure chaos. Young girls, frantic for a closer look, rushed the stage. Police, determined to do their job, gave chase. The Beatles played and sang and joked about the football game on the field. The police eventually cleared the grounds and the concert ended within a half hour. One of the promoters for the concert was WNOE Radio. Disc jockey Captain Humble recalls how the Beatles put this town on its ear when they arrived here and how his job as escort from the airport proved to be a real challenge.
We rushed them out to the Congress Inn out on the Shuffman Shore, and that's about as far as we got. We got into the lobby of the Congress Inn, and there were fans on both sides of the lobby, and I was locked in the bathroom with George. They said, go and put them in a bathroom somewhere, or go put them out of sight. So I was locked in a bathroom with George Harrison at the time, but the guys were fun-loving. They loved it.
The Congress Inn now has a new name, and most of the guests don't even know that the Beatles slept here. Rumor has it that they stayed in room 110. But a fortunate few may still have a remembrance from the Congress Inn visit.
After the concert, we had Beatle bed sheets. We got all of the sheets out of their rooms, and we cut up very, very small pieces of Beatle bed sheets. People wanted anything or everything that they could get from the Beatles.
Captain Humble remembers John Lennon as the most outgoing of the foursome when they were here. Lennon, in his last interview yesterday, recalled his past and present.
The Beatles had the top five numbers one time, right? So I can never get more than I've ever had in that respect. I'm not saying I could never have four, five numbers at once, because that's wishing myself bad luck. But let's face the reality. I've had the boyhood thing of being the Elvis and getting my own spot on the show. I want to be with my best friend, my wife. Who could ask for anything more?
When he said those words, John Lennon didn't know what future he had would be measured in hours. He died soon afterwards, with wife Yoko by his side. Seemingly a more content man than was the Liverpool rocker, who wanted to make some changes and did. And that's it.